Jim Kernzer is live this afternoon in Grosse Pointe with more on what hospital systems are doing about the problem. Jim?
The governor talked yesterday about this monoclonal antibody therapy. We're picking that up because this is what you need to know. If you test positive for COVID, talk to a doctor about getting that IV treatment. It'll keep you out of the hospital.
If given after a positive COVID test and within 10 days of the onset of the symptoms, so if somebody has a positive test and they start developing symptoms, this treatment has been shown to significantly reduce the risk of hospitalization and death by 70%.
That treatment is in partnership with the state health department. An ad campaign will be hitting the airwaves with more information. Henry Ford is feeling the pinch of the surge.
We are feeling a great pressure point, and right now we are able to accommodate because with the treatments getting better, we're able to reduce the length of stay, so we are able to move patients in and then back out of the hospital for home care and follow up treatment quicker than we could before.
Beaumont Health System near peak capacity, the medical director saying not as bad as a year ago.
So our hospitals at that time were almost, in some cases, exclusively COVID hospitals. That has not been the case right now.
Both Beaumont and Henry Ford saying staffing is their biggest concern.
The challenge here, and I think the theme of the day is, where are we going to get that staff from? You know, we can manufacture beds. We can open up beds. We can create entire wings of the hospital if we have to. But if we don't have people to staff those beds, we got nothing.
Staffing continues to be our biggest worry. We continue to redeploy those working in non-clinical areas to support the clinical areas.
And take a look at Beaumont Grosse Pointe. A triage trailer is back in business along with curbside screening to keep COVID and non-COVID patients apart. Medical staff do COVID tests, take vital signs of people inside their cars. This hasn't been done in a year.
And if the mid-level evaluates them and feels they're sick enough, they're going to be sent into the emergency room. But basically, we've had to do this because of our volumes. We have patient wait times that have become very high. We have people leaving without being seen, which, as you know, is a lot of patient safety issues.
So this is a numbers game. That doctor says they're doing everything they can to minimize these high volumes. Glenda and Alan, hospital systems tell us they expect this surge to last 2 more weeks. Back to you.
It is unbelievable where our numbers are going. Jim, appreciate the update. Alan.